As you look at this photo, what are the stars that stand out to you? For me, my eye immediately goes to this cross pattern, and this is known as the Northern Cross Asterism, and it's a very easy pattern to find in the sky. Its stars are part of the constellation called Cygnus the Swan, and the brightest star right here in this asterism is also part of another asterism called the Summer Triangle, but more on that later. In this video, we will explore how to find the shape of this pattern, get practice finding it in the night sky, and make connections to help us remember this star pattern. Welcome to Learn the Sky. My name is Janine, and I'll be your guide as we explore the night sky one constellation at a time. First, let's review what asterisms are, because they're not true constellations, but rather a simple star pattern that can be used as guides, and they can either be part of a constellation or a collection of constellations. And I've got a picture to describe this. This is an example of asterisms. They can be simple shapes, like the winter triangle that make up bright stars of three different constellations, or they can be much larger, or they can even be small patterns. And often stories will follow these different types of patterns. But here's the same picture with the constellations marked out instead. I also have a version of this with the summer sky when viewed from the Northern Hemisphere. These aren't all the constellations in this picture, but the main ones, the ones that are easier to find. But then if I switch the lens to asterisms, you have more simple patterns like the summer triangle, the Northern Cross, which is the focus of this video, but you can also have really tiny ones like the coat hanger asterism. So these are the differences between asterisms and constellations. So for this one, we're going to focus on the Northern Cross and Cygnus. So let's get some practice finding the Northern Cross in this picture. When I look at this picture, I immediately notice these three bright stars, and this is a different asterism. This is called the Summer Triangle, and I have a whole separate video on this, so be sure to go check that out if you want to learn more. But the constellation that we are looking for is Cygnus, and this is the pattern that Cygnus makes in the sky. And the Northern Cross asterism sits right within this pattern. And this picture is a longer exposure photograph, so you can see many more stars. You can see the Milky Way in the background. This is not typically a realistic picture of what you would see when you would walk outside at night, but it's a good way to practice how to learn the different patterns. And the head of the swan is a star known as Alberio, and the tail of the swan is a star known as Deneb. I've got videos on each of these, and this one's close to my heart. I named my kitty after this star, which you have to kind of go see that video about Alberio to learn why. He's kind of got two different color eyes, just like this star right here when you look at it through a telescope. That's what you would see. But back to this photo, okay, here we have the summer triangle, and then the Northern Cross is right here. This star pattern really does stand out in the sky, and it's one of the easier ones to find. So to point out the summer triangle right there, there's that asterism, and then we have the Northern Cross. Let's keep going. I have another picture for you in which we are going to look at being able to find the Northern Cross. So this is a picture of the entire summer sky. I use it often in my videos, the summer sky when viewed from the Northern Hemisphere. So the first pattern that I see right there is the summer triangle, because these three bright stars really stand out and it makes that shape. And if you can find the summer triangle, you can definitely find the Northern Cross because it's right within that pattern. This pattern also stands out. If I go back to the blank one right there, you can see the Northern Cross is right there. So let's point out some other things that are here just to get you acquainted. We have Aquila down here, and Aquila, Lyra, and Cygnus are the constellations that make up that summer triangle. And here you can see this is the pattern of the Northern Cross, and it's within the larger constellation of Cygnus the Swan. There are a bunch of other constellations here. We've got Scorpius, which is very obvious to see in this photo, Sagittarius, which is known as its own asterism called the Teapot. We have Ophiuchus, Libra, and Again, you can see some of these when you click off of them. So I hope this is helpful with giving you some practice on how to find the Northern Cross in the sky. For me, it's all about finding that summer triangle, and from there, I can figure out where the cross is going to be. As I was researching this topic, I discovered that the Northern Cross is not the only cross in the sky, and I was aware of one called the Southern Cross because I've done a video on this. This is also known as the constellation called Crux, but there's also a Diamond Cross and a False Cross. So these three are very close to each other in the Southern Hemisphere, so I'm going to show those to you using Stellarium and a video because I don't really have great pictures of this. But just something interesting to think about, that the Northern Cross is not the only cross asterism that exists. In the next portion of this video, I want to use Stellarium, which is a great online planetarium software, to help you find where the crosses are, the cross asterisms in the Southern Hemisphere. So since I don't live in the Southern Hemisphere, I've only really seen some of these, like the Southern Cross right there. But as you look at this, I kind of have the atmosphere turned on. I can turn it off and see all the beautiful stuff in the background that we can't see when we go outside. This is the realistic view of what you're going to see. So right here, my eyes are drawn to this pattern right here. This is the Southern Cross. Okay, and the Southern Cross will point towards these two stars. This is Alpha and Beta Centauri. These stars are very close to our own solar system. But anyway, the other cross pattern right here, this is the False Cross. And then right here, this is the Diamond Cross. So now that you kind of orient yourself as to where you should be looking, the three crosses right here, now I'm going to kind of take away the atmosphere. And now they're a little bit harder to see, but you can still see the Southern Cross. Here is the False Cross, and here is the Diamond Cross. And now I'll put the constellation borders on. This makes it even more difficult to find personally, but the Southern Cross is easy because that one is a constellation pattern. But here's the False Cross. It kind of connects these two constellations, Carina and Vela. And then, let's see, that's where the Diamond Cross is as well. That's part of this constellation. So I'm going to toggle all of this back to what it originally looked like. And I hope this was helpful for you to find, you know, where these are. This is not something I see from where I live. And that's, you know, you can see this is where the horizon would be. And if I turn that on, you can see I'm not able to see this from where my location is. So anyway, those are the three Southern Cross asterisms. Let's get some practice finding the three crosses in the Southern Hemisphere. Here you can see the Southern Cross, the Diamond Cross, and the False Cross. The Diamond Cross to me stands out because at the one tip you have the Southern Pleiades, which is a small star cluster. Now I would like to use Stellarium to help us explore where Cygnus and the Northern Cross is. So I already typed where it is. This is what Cygnus looks like in the night sky, but I'm going to turn a few things off. Okay, I love this because it shows you the constellation border and it also shows you the pattern within. So you can turn all of this off, and if I click here, that'll turn it off as well. And as soon as I am looking at this, I can immediately see the Northern Cross right there. It's so obvious. And then here you can see the summer triangle pattern as well. So if we're going to zoom in here, I love Stellarium because it shows you where the satellites are. And you can click on here to learn more about these different types of stars, such as how far away it is, what its magnitude is, and a little bit more information about that particular star. But this is the Northern Cross right here. Okay, and if you zoom out, or I like turning the atmosphere on and off. This is more of a realistic version of what you would see versus if we take the atmosphere away and you can see more of the Milky Way in the background. And that's something important to realize, is that the Northern Cross sits right in the Milky Way galaxy, and that's another place you can look for. Look for that band of light across the sky and see if you can find the Northern Cross within it. We've come to the end of our video about the Northern Cross Asterism located in Cygnus the Swan. So let's review everything we've learned so far. It's best seen in June, July, and August, which is the summer months for the Northern Hemisphere and winter for the Southern Hemisphere. But ultimately, your latitude will determine how long you can really see this for. The best way to find it is look for the giant cross within the summer triangle asterism. So again, if we were to look at this photo, this pattern right here is the summer triangle, and you want to find the Northern Cross within it. So I hope this video was helpful for you in learning how to find this asterism. I think it's one of the easier ones to find. It's very obvious in the sky. So I wish you luck finding it. Remember, take somebody outside with you to keep you company. And as always, keep looking up.